We left off from the companion video where I said that service crew are worth it. They will affect non-combat ships. I'll show you the steps for setting up the experiment. I very much encourage you to also run this if the results interest you. More data is almost always a good thing. There will be a bit of math, but we will keep it simple. No derivatives here. For the test ships, I am using the Argon Federation. They seem to be the baseline that everyone is compared against. I gave them the best equipment and chose all-around engines, as the AI aren't the best with travel engines and there is no combat version for large ships. All ships were given the best service crew I had available, under the assumption that any effect would scale with the engineer skill. The pilot was kept at 2 stars, as 3-star pilots would normally upgrade it to auto traders, so for sector mining this will be the best pilot you would normally use. That same pilot was also used for every ship to remove that variable. Everyone was given an unnecessarily large escort of 23 fighters to deal with any kayak, although no enemies showed up for these test runs. So that's good, one less thing to account for. All behavior was set to ignore except for police interdiction and pirate harassment, as those options were just not available. Finally, a quick save to retain the same reference point, and then I ran SATA for 10 minutes to simulate 1 hour of real time. Once the time was up, I sold what was remaining in the hold and added everything up. With all that setup out of the way, what did we find? The crewed miner had, on average, a 39% increase in silicon. The reason that you see such variance between the test runs is because as soon as you set it to sector auto mine, the ship just went everywhere. Sometimes it would mine the asteroid right next to it, other times it would fly to the other side of the sector. Adding randomness to AI behavior is a good game mechanic, but it adds unnecessary randomness when conducting these types of tests. Initially, I was going to run the tests in sets of 3, as that is the minimum amount of data points you need to verify a pattern, but because of how the AI reacted, I increased it to 6 runs each. What about the small ships? Once again, I gave it all the best equipment available with all-around engines. Even though I had enough specialists, I gave it an able crewman to keep the ratio similar to the medium miner. This time, the results were even more pronounced. The small miner had an average increase of 47%. Now, this ship spent most of its time flying between the asteroids and the station, as it only took 1 or 2 rocks to fill up its hold. So it looks like the service crew has a greater effect on ship maneuverability than other systems, such as how effective it is at using the mining laser in this case. As I stated earlier on how you need 3 data points to verify a pattern, luckily for us, there is a third ship that is the complete opposite of the small miner that we can use as a contrast. Of course, that's the large miner. This ship is using 10 mining drones, instead relying on the station for the cargo drones. I didn't have enough specialists to maintain the same ratio, but the remainder is still made up of at least able crewmen. Now, a large miner spends most of its time in one spot, and has the mining drones do all the gathering for it. Our hypothesis after seeing the results from the small miner was that service crew affect maneuverability more than anything else. So for a ship that doesn't move, we should see the smallest increase. And that's exactly what we do see with that 29%. However, what is interesting are the results from the individual test runs. The uncrewed miner performed better than both the small and medium uncrewed ships, but the crewed large miner, while it did perform better, it was only just better. Considering how much more it costs, you would expect a larger performance increase, but it was just on par with the medium miner. That's the end of the video. I know I said I would run tests on the traders as well, but those results were all over the place. The miners would act semi-randomly, but at least they were restricted to a single sector. The auto traders were bouncing across the entire galaxy. The variance in results was just too high. I might revisit this in another video if I can come up with a way to reduce that said variance, but until then I feel like it's safe to assume that the results would be comparable to the miners. But before we go, if you liked the video, if you found it helpful, please give a click to all the good buttons at the bottom and share so that more people can see it. Until next time, fly safe.